Okay, so by now you should all be aware that we are planning on building a performance engine. But before we do, we should strip down this hydrogen engine here. It's been running on hydrogen for the past 2 years, but it started to develop some piston slap or wear inside the engine. So today we'll be stripping this down. This is currently what the engine sounds like. So it doesn't sound too bad, but when I take out the spark plug, you can hear some knocking inside the engine, something metal on metal, something that's not quite right, which sounds like this. So as you could hear, there's something not 100% there, so let's strip this down and find out. First, let's inspect the oil. That doesn't look good. Yep, so there's still plenty of oil in there, which isn't great. And there's the oil. So, not looking good at all. Let's carry on stripping this down. Let me know what you think of this oil in the comments. Let's have a look at the spark plug. Doesn't look too bad as far as spark plugs go. Looks a little bit corroded. Not sure what could cause that. Perhaps the water content inside. But again, let me know your thoughts in the comments. Okay, so I can't actually take this off because it's locked in or seized onto the actual drive shaft of the engine. So I'm going to have to make a tool to pull this out. Okay, moment of truth. So first look inside the engine, everything looks pretty normal. Seems to be a lot of play on the conrod here, which could be the noise that we're hearing. But the only way to find out is by taking it off and having a look. I'll now take off the valves and take off cylinder head, and we'll have this whole engine stripped down. Thank you. Okie dokie.
Last time I took this off, it had lots of signs of pitting. It was also a bright golden colour from heat due to poor ignition timing. Since then I've polished it. This was when I first got the engine. I just took the cylinder head off. I left a piston on and just polished this up, masking everything else off around it. It looks like it stayed that way. That's why it's nice and clean. There's a bit of oil in there. I had to use WD-40 to start this engine the last time I ran it. So this is probably residue from WD-40 or something like that. So if we have a look at this cylinder head, again, it doesn't look too bad. No signs of pitting. But what we're gonna do is lap these valves to reseat them, as it has been a pain to start. So I'll pop these valves off later on, but for now let's carry on stripping down the actual engine. Okay, so as you can see, the whole engine is now completely stripped out and laid out on this table here, so we can inspect every component. I'm not going to bore you by showing you every component. I'm just going to show you the components that have failed, which is what was causing the whole knocking. So the crankshaft has failed. There's extreme gouges inside where the conrod sits, and the conrod also has big gouges in the aluminium. So there it is. Hopefully you can see that there, the gouges in the metal. So that is what's failed. That's what's causing the knocking. I thought it was the piston side with the piston pin, but it was not. Piston's absolutely fine. It's nice and clean. There's no carbon buildup, obviously, because there's no carbon when burning hydrogen. So in theory, when running hydrogen, it should stay that shiny all the time. When I disassembled the engine, it was covered in slight oil residue and WD-40. That is because towards the end of this engine's life, I had to use WD-40 or a small amount of petrol to start the engine because it was just backfiring otherwise. And that's because of the poor quality of the valve seats. As you can see, this is the exhaust valve, and it's not shiny at all, and it's very poor connection with the valve seat on the actual cylinder head. The intake valve is much better. There's a bit more shine to it. The contact area where it sits on the valve seat is absolutely fine. I'm going to be lapping the valves and potentially getting new valves because the valves are slightly bent. I don't know if that is a cause or if it's because of poor ignition timing. Not too sure, but I'll get new valves anyway. They're only slightly bent. I do believe they'll still work, but might as well replace them anyway. The cylinder head, also nice and shiny, no carbon build up here. The exhaust side, again, the bit cruddy. Not have to lap this again, but it's all still very much usable. The engine rebuild I got for this engine is actually just for the top sides of the piston and all the gaskets. Obviously, it's clear now that that isn't the issue, and it's the conrod. So, new conrod, new crank. I might as well put the new piston in anyway and completely rebuild it. Right, so now we know exactly why the engine failed and what we need to do to fix it. I was going to buy a new engine for the performance engine that we're going to be building, so we start fresh. But now looking at this engine in bits, I might as well just buy the parts that have failed and fix it. It'll save money that way, and there's no point in wasting a perfectly good engine if we can use it. So that's what I'll do. I'll just buy the bits, and then we'll use this engine block and all its components for the performance engine that we're going to be building. Big shout out to Dan Maycock and Aaron Duffy, who sent a donation through PayPal to help support this channel. So thank you guys for doing that. It's a big help. Anyone else wants to help donate towards this channel? The PayPal link is below. If you do donate through PayPal, I'll give you a shout out on this channel. So it's been interesting stripping this engine down. We've got a few replacement parts. So next time we'll be rebuilding the engine, increasing the compression, and hopefully getting a bit more power. See you next time.